fires continue to ravage the Pantanal, the world's largest tropical wetland in western Brazil. The blaze gradually crawling towards the Bolivian border. The region has suffered from weak rain since late last year, leaving the area vulnerable to fires. Data show the blaze increased by 980% compared with the same period last year. Scientists in Bolivia are on a mission to track changes in glaciers real time with the help of new technology. Take a look.
These Bolivian scientists are hoping to track melting glaciers at lightning speed.
Yeah, it's too many.
But they're installing new equipment at the Huayna Potosi mountain peak, which will provide real-time measurements of glaciers' mass. Glaciologist Edson Ramirez says the new technology can make hourly measurements much faster than traditional methods capable of monthly or yearly readings.
It will allow us to know exactly what that melting rate is and other characteristics of the glacier, such as how much life is still left for a glacier.
Glaciers play a significant role in water supply across the Andes mountain range. Studies show they provide almost 30% of the water in Bolivia's Cordillera Real region in the dry season. Extreme weather events like heat waves and droughts have stressed water supplies throughout South America, making more accurate glacier measurements a critical tool. Gerd Durkon is the head of the Soil, Water Management and Crop Nutrition Laboratory at the joint FAO and IAEA Center of Nuclear Techniques in Food and Agriculture. He says faster measurements of glaciers will help create a baseline.
You can't take measures or prepare yourself for the future if you don't know where you are. If the situation would be great, it would even be also good to know it's great. But when the situation is bad, it's even more important to know the situation, the baseline. And from the baseline, you can then take actions. You can improve your reservoir capacity. You can make sure as well that the water demand is, of course, adjusted, or that you need as well to think about more reservoirs.
President Marcos leads the inauguration of a solar-powered pump irrigation project in Isabela province. According to the government, the project will irrigate 350 hectares of rice field, benefiting over 200 farmers. Mr. Marcos says the project is meant to address rising energy costs as well as the effects of El Nino on the agriculture sector.
Mabuti na lang na meron na tayong bagong teknolohiya itong solar. Dahil kung maalala ninyo, yung ginagamit natin, mga pump, mga diesel, mahalang krudo at mahalang maintenance at saka maliit lang yung mga bomba natin dati. Kaya ito ay napakalaking bagay. Kahit na umabot na makarating na naman ang El Nino, bumalik ang katuyot na magtagtuyot, ay meron din tayong maasahan na water supply, hindi lamang para sa irrigation, kung hindi pati na para sa water supply ng ating mga consumer.
A new way of purifying water envisioned to help end the reliance on plastic bottled water. If Water, based in Glasgow, Scotland, uses mechanical vapor compression technology to create pure distilled water that is safe to drink and leaves any contaminants behind. The patent-pending device uses no chemicals that can clog up and reduce efficiency while using less energy. The system is capable of producing up to 250 liters a day.
22,000 properties in Scotland are reliant on private water supplies like wells, boreholes and springs. And 14% of those have been found to have E. coli in them. In the UK, there are 75,000 of these properties. But globally, the problem is much bigger, with two-thirds of the world's population facing water shortages or lack of clean drinking water. It's a problem that's only going to get worse as climate change increases and water quality access to water quality gets harder.
Around the world, almost 1 million plastic bottles are purchased every minute, contributing to the single-use containers that are clogging the world's waterways.